There once was a king who had a swineherd called John. One morning, both John and the king noticed that outside the palace grew an apple tree that reached the sky. But this was no ordinary tree, for it blossomed in the morning, bore fruit by noon, and by midnight the apples were ripe. However, every apple was soon stolen, and the king hadn't even tasted one. So the king sent out a proclamation throughout the land that anyone who brought him an apple from the tree could marry his daughter and have half his realm, and the rest of it after his death. You see, the king had been ill for 7 years, and an old woman had told him that should an apple tree grow beneath his window, and should he eat of the fruit, he would be cured at once. So he sent out the proclamation to all four corners of the land that anyone, be he rich or poor, baron or count, anyone who brought him one of the apples could marry his daughter, the princess. Well, there was no lack of applicants, but none could climb the tree. Then John, the little swineherd, said to the king, "Your Majesty, if I may be so bold, let me go up that tree and bring down an apple."
"What?" laughed the king. "Do you want to climb where neither count nor prince could climb? Oh, nonsense! Go back to your work."
But John the swineherd would not leave the king in peace. He kept on begging until the king gave him permission.
All right," sighed the king. "And what will you need, pray tell? How are you going to climb the tree? I will give you whatever you need."
"Your Majesty should have 3 iron rings made to girdle the tree, so that I can climb up them like a ladder. And I will also need 3 pairs of iron boots, and enough food for a week," said John. So when all these things were ready, John set out to climb the tree. He climbed so high that day, he could no longer be seen. He went on climbing for 3 more days until he noticed that one of his boots had a hole in it, and the iron was rubbing his foot. So he pulled off his boots and let them drop far below. "Let them return to my master," he cried.
"Well," said the king when the boot dropped down, "that boy is still alive, though he has already had to change his boots."
When John reached the 7th branch of the tree, he found a staircase that he could climb easily from now on. "I'm grateful to the king for his help," he thought. "I'll drop down the 2nd pair of boots as well, so he can see I'm still alive, and I'll drop down the axe also, as I won't be needing it any longer." He was so high up when he dropped the axe that by the time it reached the ground, the handle had rotted away completely. And by the time the boots fell down to the royal palace, they had grown so old that nobody recognized them. Nobody except the guard, that is, who had been appointed to stand under the tree and report as soon as John sent down any signals or messages. By the 7th day, all 3 pairs of boots had worn out, but on that day John reached the top of the tree. Now the boy did not give the king another thought, for he was so high up that he'd almost forgotten why he was there at all. After a time, he found himself in a large castle. He walked through the 1st hall, then the 2nd, then the 3rd, and on, until he reached the 11th hall. There he found a beautiful girl, more beautiful than any he had ever seen. The king's daughter was beautiful, too, but even she paled beside this pretty maid. "Good day, fair maiden. Forgive me, I do not know whether to call you a princess or not," said John politely.
"My name is Zetelka. I am a princess and an orphan," replied the girl. "My parents are both dead. But tell me, how did you come here, higher than any bird ever flies?"
Well, John was so stunned by her beauty that he stammered, "I have come to serve you."
"Then you came in good time, as I am all alone. You may stay with me as long as you like. Whatever you ask, I will grant, but you must never enter the 12th room."
The lad promised to put everything in order and to work like a bee. So they agreed, and he remained with the princess, and he even dined with her every evening. And it came to pass that after a while together they fell in love and became betrothed. Then one day the princess said to John,
I'm going to church now. Here are the keys to 11 rooms. Clean them all thoroughly and cook supper. Everything is ready. All you have to do is light the fire. But whatever you do, don't look for the key to the 12th room.
And with this, she set off. John did everything he had been told, and did not give a thought to what might be in the 12th room. But once he had finished his chores, he could not stop wondering what might be there, and went in search of the key to the 12th room in order to clean it. It must have been ages since it was last done. He saw an old broom standing in a corner. He decided to throw it away and put a new one in its place. But as he picked it up, the door of the 12th room began to open, and he wasted no time but went in. And bang! Right away the door closed behind him. Well, guess what? His eyes nearly popped out of his head, for there, nailed to the wall, was a seven-headed dragon. Two huge iron balls that must have weighed at least 50 tons hung from its...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.